Okay. Show me.
Hooray, guys! Welcome back to the Dusty Sheet Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. What have I got for you today? This is a Gap RC KHX Elegant 5-inch freestyle quadcopter, right? Now, I hear you think, well, Mr. Dutch RC, this is nothing new. You've shown us several of these. Yeah, but wait, this is an RTF version here. The previous ones I had were all built by myself. Well, built, assembled. This is how it came out of the box, ready to fly. Well, you have to add a LiPo, of course, and a transmitter, but that's it. It comes pre-assembled, even with a receiver. I think there's also a version without a receiver, by the way, but I got the one with FR Sky receiver. So I am very excited. I love these quadcopters, as you probably know by now. The frames not only look great, but they fly very well, partly because the weight distribution is excellent on this quadcopter, better than on most quadcopters if you want to fly freestyle. This quadcopter is not intended for racing at all. I think Gap RC says it can be used for racing, but well, obviously it can, but it's not intended for racing at all. This is a freestyle quadcopter. So, in this video we'll take an in-depth look into this quadcopter, what you get for your money and if it's any good. See if there are positive surprises here and maybe even negative ones. And there is one negative thing to this quadcopter, a minor, well, you'll have to decide. But let's take a step back and see what you actually get when you order this quadcopter. Alright guys, this is Dr. Cheese from the past. At the moment I'm shooting this part of the video, I haven't touched the box. Well, I have touched the box, but I haven't opened the box. So together we'll have a look what we get when we order this elegant 5-inch quadcopter RTF from Gap RC. Let's see what positive or negative surprises this box contains. I'm very excited to finally have this quad in. Let's see. This is an instruction manual thing for the receiver. FR Sky RXSR receiver this quadcopter comes with. Very nice. What is this? Okay, documentation of the flight stack, I guess. Of the flight controller and ESC, 4-in-1 ESC. Now this, in case you're not familiar with it, this quadcopter contains the span tower from Gap RC. Now, in case you think, wow, Gap RC developed their own flight stack, flight controller and ESCs. Nah, that's not the case. For instance, LDRRC sells the exact same flight stack. That's not a bad thing at all. But again, this is not developed by Gap RC. And it's an F405 flight stack. 40 amp ESCs, which is very nice. And it has an VTX included in this board as well. Okay, very nice. Oh, you get some decals. I have to say, I'm always glad to get decals, but I never really end up using them. Do you ever use the decals that come with RCs? With cars, for instance, I generally do end up using decals, but on quadcopters, okay. But still appreciate it. Okay, foam protection. Ah, there is our quadcopter. Cool stuff, man. Now, I am already very much familiar with these quadcopters. This is my fourth elegant quadcopter, as you probably know. But this is the RTF version. Cool stuff, man. Yeah, I love these quadcopters. Okay, more on the quadcopter itself in a second. And what is this? Hey, a pagoda antenna. Now, as you can see, the quadcopter itself has a pagoda antenna, and you get an extra one, but it's a different one. This one on the quadcopter has an MMCX connector. You can't really see it, but well, oh, you can over here see that it has a thin strand. I hope you can see that. Where this extra one, I think the idea is that you use this one, the extra one, on your goggle, right? And some people say that if you run a pagoda antenna on your quadcopter, it's ideal to also use a pagoda antenna on your goggle. And in case that's true, well, very nice. I've actually never come across a quadcopter that comes with a antenna for your goggle. Have you? Huh, very nice, man. So, yeah, this is above and beyond, I think, so very nice. Okay, you get a care package. Okay, I will take a closer look at the content in a second. And you get, well, quite a number of propellers. This is 4 sets, or maybe even 5. I think it's 4 sets. I was kind of expecting just 1 set. And now these are Gap RC branded propellers, 50-40, 3 blades obviously, but they look very much like HQ V1S props, very much like those. Yeah, they definitely are Gap RC branded, but again, they look kind of identical. Yeah, they look identical to the HQ prop V1S 5040. So that kind of means that these are actually usable propellers. That's nice. We'll put that to the test, of course, but they don't look bad at all. And again, I am surprised to see that you get so many sets. Three spare sets of propellers. Cool stuff. Okay, let's get into a little more detail here. Alright, let's get the slightly boring stuff out of the way. This care package, what's in it? Are there any more surprises here? You get a lot of stuff with this quadcopter. Okay, you get 3 battery straps. Well, 1 action camera strap, which you will attach to the camera cage. And the other 2 straps are to strap down your battery. Yeah, the intent with this quadcopter is that you use 2 straps to tie down your battery, which is a good thing, I think. If you buy this frame separately, you'll also get 3 straps. So that's nice. You get some cut out foam pieces that will go onto the bottom of the quadcopter over here. And as you can see, you get 2 extra sets. So that's nice. And you also get that same treatment with just the frame. You get an all-purpose foam pad on the ones I built myself. I used a little on the bottom plate to prevent it scratching up in landings. And you get some more foam. These are long strips, and the intent of those is that you put them on the cage, the front cage, the camera cage, to act as vibration dampeners for your action camera, right? Personally, I don't use them yet. The builds I've done so far didn't produce a lot of vibration, but well, nice to get that. And these are anti-slip mats for your battery, so they go on top of the frame. And you actually get a spare one. Now, that's an extra. If you buy this frame, you only get 1. So that's nice. After a while, that rubbery stuff gets a little drier or harder, right? So I guess at that point you just rip it off and use the second one. And you can probably buy these separately as well. By now, all frame parts of these elegant frames are available as well. So, cool stuff. You get some arm protectors, four of them, 3D printed. And yeah, you can install those if you feel you need those. And that'll definitely help in preventing damage to the ends of the arms over here. So I guess that's nice. And this is also an extra. If you order the frame separately, you don't get these arm protectors. If you have a 3D printer of your own, you can obviously print them yourself. But, well, an extra, and I didn't expect to get these, so that's nice. This is a very nice surprise. You get one extra arm, a spare arm. And yes, all arms on this quadcopter are identical, so whichever arm you break first, you can use this arm for. And I think it's nice that you get a spare arm. And yes, the latest 5-inch from Emacs also comes with one or two spare arms. But, as you probably know, most quadcopters don't come with a spare arm. So this is a nice touch. Thank you very much. You get some tools and caps for the antenna protector tube. This tube over here. And as you can see, it already has these end caps, but you get two spares, some Allen keys. Okay, thank you very much. You get two spare screws. That's a little sober, right? Only two spare screws. Yeah, it's more than nothing, but come on, just throw in a complete set of spare screws, maybe. Yeah, okay. And you get a control board for the FPV camera, as this quadcopter comes with a Runcam Swift version 2. With this control board you can set that up, change the settings of the camera, the exposure and the color, the WR settings and such. And so it's nice to get that control board for it. Thank you very much. And the last thing is a spare antenna tube. As you can see, it already has that tube installed, and well, you can probably make four extra ones of this tube. So nice to get that in the box as well. So that's the care package. Now let's have a closer look at the quadcopter itself. All right, the star of the show, the GAPRC KHX5 Elegant. The frame itself, by the way, is available in 6, maybe even 7 inch. I'm not sure. I've only had the 5 inch so far. Maybe in the future I'll build a 7 inch. But anyway, why do I like these frames so much? Well, as you can imagine, this is a top-mounted frame, so the battery goes on top over here. All electronics are mounted below the top plate. This is not the only frame in its kind, but as you can see, the motors and the battery, which are the most the heaviest parts of the quadcopter, are in line with each other, right? That way your center of mass will be in line with even in line with the FPV camera. More or less, the FPV camera is positioned slightly lower, but that makes for a very predictable and smooth flying FPV quadcopter. And this being a freestyle quadcopter, that's what you want, right? You don't want the optimum in speed. This is definitely not a quad designed for racing. It would be smaller, more compact, less air resistance. So yeah, apart from that, it's of high quality. I've had several GAPRC quadcopters by now, and if you've ever had a GAPRC quadcopter, you know, for instance, the MX3 is, to me, kind of best of its class in terms of build quality. I've never been able to crack an arm on a GAPRC quadcopter. That does not mean that they are indestructible, of course. But this is definitely high quality carbon fiber. And that's part of the reason that this is not the cheapest quadcopter around, but it's approximately, at the time of this shooting of this video, approximately 225 euros. And I think that's it's not a bargain, but it's definitely not expensive for an RTF quadcopter, or bind and fly, basically quadcopter. Okay, the carbon fiber is of nice quality. This cage, the camera cage, is made out of 70-75 aluminium. And that means that this kind of aluminium is not very bendable. I'm not sure what kind of aluminium, the 60 range of aluminium, 60-65, I think, is more bendable. That would make this cage be kind of an crumple zone, right, in a crash. You could basically then bend it back, but in real life you'd never be able to bend it back to the shape it was. I'm sure you're familiar with that. So this is a harder type of aluminium. That also means it will shatter, break at some point. And so, yeah, if you run this quadcopter into a wall, this cage might shatter. If that's a better or worse than a bendable cage, I'm not completely sure. But this is what Gepa C went with, and it sure does feel sturdy. Okay, so the arms are 4 millimeter. The entire top plate basically is 4 millimeter, and at the bottom you've got a plate which is 2 millimeter. It does stiffen up the frame a bit, but it's not really part of the integral structure of the frame. And you've got these side plates right on either side. Those are only 1 millimeters, and they only act as protection for your flight stick, kinda, to keep dirt out of the quadcopter. And yeah, that also means that if you get dirt into your quadcopter, it's harder to get it out. And as you can see, I've already put the skids, this foam, onto the quadcopter, and I've also put this rubber mat for your battery onto the quadcopter. Now, this is a bind and fly version, right? So it comes with a receiver, and the first thing I wondered was if you can actually reach the receiver. Now, it's mounted at the bottom over here, and I'm glad to say you can actually reach the bind button on the receiver. So you don't, it wouldn't be a big job to take the bottom plate off, but you don't have to. You can reach the bind button without taking your quadcopter apart. So that's nice. What you can also easily reach is the USB connector over here to update the settings of Betaflight. Speaking of, this quadcopter came with Betaflight 3.3.5, I think. I'm not completely sure. I'll put it on screen. By now I've already updated it to 3.5, so the latest version at the moment I'm shooting this here video. Now, at this point it might be interesting to show you the differences in build between this one and one that I've built myself. Okay, the RTF or bind the fly version over here. And this is the kind of the same quadcopter, but this one I built myself, or assembled myself. Now, there are definitely differences, even though they look very much the same. The one I built myself has Emax motors on it. These are 2207 motors. These are 2306 motors. Now, I kind of prefer 2207 motors, but in a few minutes we'll see if this this probably works. The amount of power should be approximately the same, but the power curve should be a little different. Okay, I've got a different FEV antenna on it, as you can see, and the one of the really big differences is how I've mounted my flight stick. As you can hopefully see, my battery lead comes out of the frame at the front, behind my FPV camera. This is my battery lead. And I very much prefer this method. There is no way this lead will get stuck in, will get in contact with my propellers. Where this one over here, the bind and fly version, has the battery lead come out of the side over here. And yeah, the propellers are definitely pretty far away, but once you put a battery on and I'm sure this will work, but personally I do prefer this. I've built all my other Gap RC quadcopters like this. They do both have the same FPV camera, by the way, Runcam Swift version 2. So I guess that's a good choice in my book. I love these FPV cameras. And well, that's basically it. Yeah, they both have a big capacitor on my own. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that, but mine has a capacitor over here at the front behind the FPV camera. The Bindafly version has a very big capacitor over here inside of the frame, and I'm not sure if it'll show up in camera, but it does. So we'll see how that works out. I assume this quadcopter will have a clean FPV signal, but again, we'll see. Okay, oh yeah, and one last difference. My receiver antenna are situated over here, as you can see, whereas the Bindafly version has them over here. And yeah, they are not at 90 degrees opposed to each other, right? Yeah. This does look nice, I have to say, but again. Oh, and my FPV antenna is further away from the carbon fiber. So there is a lower chance of my FPV antenna being blocked, or the FPV signal being blocked by the frame. This one has its FPV antenna pretty close to the frame. So yeah, I would have liked that to be a little further out. That's just me. Tell me what you think, but I think this should work better. Okay, so much for the differences. Okay, so thus far I've been very positive about this quadcopter, right? And I guess that makes sense because I ordered it thinking, or at least hoping, it would be a good quadcopter. I've had quite a lot of experience with Gap RC products thus far. They have worked well for me. So yeah, that led me to believe that this would be a good quadcopter. However, there are obviously negative things to any product. I already mentioned that FPV antenna being pretty close to the carbon fiber frame and your battery. How well or badly that'll work, we'll have to see in my flight videos. But yeah, we'll just see. There is, however, one really stupid, yeah, that's the right word, stupid thing about this quadcopter. It has a receiver, right? It's mounted over here. It is an FRSky RXSR receiver. Yay, that's a pretty nice receiver, as you probably know. And that has telemetry. That's nice. So your radio will know the status of your flight battery and the reception and such. Very, very nice. Again, a nice receiver. However, they haven't hooked up the smart port to the flight controller. So actually you don't have telemetry. They have enabled telemetry in Betaflight, which does nothing like this. And I'm not even sure. There's only one spare UART, but maybe that's reserved for the USB port, UART 1. So yeah, it's a bit strange. Why did they actually use an RXSR receiver? They might as well have used an XM Plus receiver this way. Would have been exactly the same. So that's definitely a bit weird in my mind. And the next really negative thing, support. Over the last year, I've shot Gap RC a couple of emails with questions, suggestions, and I have never gotten an answer.
Disappointed!
So, if I don't get an answer with a channel. Okay, my channel obviously isn't very big, but it's not super small either. So if they don't answer me, I'm not sure what kind of support you as a end user would get. Now, I'm also not completely sure what kind of support you would need, but again, like me, maybe you have a certain technical question. It would be nice for them to reply, right? At least. But again, I have never gotten any kind of reply from GapRC to emails.
Disappointed!
But, well, again, GapRC quadcopter, and from my experience, those are nice quadcopters. They make high quality products. Yeah, that receiver is really silly, and no support is, yeah, you be the judge. But so far, those are the only negative things about this quadcopter. All right, ooh la la, a family shot of all my GapRC elegant quadcopters. Doesn't that look delicious? Okay, let me not waste more of your time by going over all of the specifications of this quadcopter. If you are interested in the specifications of this quadcopter, they are in the description of this video. There is also a link to this quadcopter in the description of this video. There you can obviously check if the quadcopter is actually available at the current price. And there are more specifications on the product page. And you'll also be supporting this channel, Dutch RC Adventures, by using that link. Thank you very much in advance. Now, I had actually wanted to also do at least a line of sight test flight with this quadcopter now in this video. However, the weather is a bit, rainy and such. So, what I'll do is I'll do that in a separate video. And in that separate video, I'll actually compare it to one of my self-built elegant quadcopters. So, that'll be coming up pretty soon, I hope. Weather permitting. For now, if you have questions about this quadcopter or anything else, hit me up a comment down below and I'll be happy to answer you. And catch you on the next video. Bye bye.